Brandon here from Permanent Mounts. Welcome to another episode of The Peak. Today we're at the Los Angeles CDA Tech Summit, and we're here meeting with Alesia Hendley.
Yo, yo.
If you guys don't know, Alesia was part of SCN of the Nine in 2018. I'm a new member, SCN the Nine, member of 2019, which is super awesome.
Yay!
So I guess we're kind of just going to combine like what we know and what we do and kind of give some people like some things to be excited about in terms of being youngsters in AV, kind of capturing that element and what we kind of see for the future. So first and foremost, let us know where you're at now. Like, what's been current with you?
Hey, being on the Nine was like, it totally changed my life. A lot of companies started to recognize me in the industry. And now I work for a manufacturer. And I like to think that, you know, the Nine had a part to play in that. Like I said, I got a lot of recognition from being a part of such a great group. You won't be able to top our class, but still, congratulations to y'all, you know. But it's just an awesome feeling to be recognized within the industry and being so young as well.
Yeah.
So, like I said, now I work for a manufacturer, and I like to think that the Nine had a lot to do with that.
It helps kind of seeing different perspectives too.
Like, yeah, for sure.
Being on, you know, someone who does the installation versus someone who makes the product, like now you're kind of getting a big sense of like how the ecosystem works. I think that's super
Yeah. And that's a great thing about this industry, right? You could be an end user one day, you could be a manufacturer the next day, or you could be an integrator. Like, there's so many sides to this industry, and as a young person coming into it, being able to have those opportunities from so many different perspectives is something that's it's invaluable, you know, because you get to have conversations from all those different point of views.
Very true. So what was the feeling like when you kind of got notified, hey, you're going to be part of the Nine?
There it is.
Man, I'm in a group with so many people that I considered friends, and it was right around Infocom. We were all going to be in the place at the same time, and everybody, there was all this hype, and everybody wanted to meet us, like all the old heads wanted to come and meet us, and like I was like, okay, this is really, really cool to be a part of. And then we all got together and just celebrated life and the opportunity that we had to be a part of this group and meet people we hadn't met before. So I was really excited. Like, it's not every day you're featured in a magazine as somebody to, you know, pay attention to or look out for. So it was just an unbelievable moment. And it was a great vibe all around, seriously.
Nice. Yeah, I think it's kind of a similar thing with me. Like, I wasn't really expecting it, but when the opportunity came and they were able to say, hey, you know, we want to feature you and give you a platform to kind of advocate the message, I was super appreciative of that just because there's so much to talk about.
Right.
You know, the industry is always evolving and always changing. So I guess that kind of segments into my next question, like, well, what are you super excited for in the industry today? Whether it's, you know, 6 months down the line, 1 year down the line, like, what are you hyped to see? And kind of tell everyone why you're excited for.
Congratulations on being on the Nine, by the way.
Thank you.
that's a huge success for any class, whether it's just my class, future class, or previous classes. Like, that's an awesome achievement within the AV industry for sure. So congratulations, bro.
Thank you. Yeah, I appreciate it.
But looking forward, I'm really excited to see where IT goes. And that's part of the reason why I joined the manufacturer I work for now, Access Networks. We deploy, you know, enterprise-grade solutions on the networking side, but it's not only an IT company, it's an AV company. So it's exciting because as an end user, I was using so much gear, and it was all over the network, and the network would go down, and our whole team is like just standing around looking like, what do we do now? You know, so I really wanted to put myself in a position to where I could not only understand the network, but understand how to fix the network if something happens. So that's what I'm interested in seeing because, man, everything's over the network.
Yeah, seriously, AV over IP is like the big buzzword in the industry right now. So we tend to see that a lot in terms of how, you know, real time is shown in prime time.
Right.
And how to kind of make sure that all the parts and pieces are in place to make sure that it's seamless across everything.
Right, and our whole industry is seeing it, right? From a residential point of view, from a commercial point of view, from a digital signage point of view, you know, the network has to be a strong foundation. So I got on board early.
Nice, there you go. I mean, that's the best way to do it.
That's right.
So, you know, we've talked about what you're excited about, right? But, you know, part of being in the Nine is, how you're going to define the industry going forward.
Right.
So what are some things that you've noticed in the industry that you might want to change or you might want to enhance moving forward? just to kind of strengthen the industry as a whole?
I started in this industry at a good time too, because that's more when Infocom was talking about the experience, and experience is a huge buzzword overall, but that's honestly what it's always been about for me. Whether I was an end user creating an experience for another end user, or being an end user working with integrators and not happy with the interaction and the experience there. So that's something that I get really excited about, bro.
Nice.
The experience overall, and that's what I feel like my role in the industry is. And I want to help others learn about the experience that comes with the AV industry. So a huge conversation that I'm going to have this year at Infocom is how do we interact with the younger audience, and not even just younger than us, but people our age, about the AV industry overall, how to get into it, because everybody in this generation and younger wants to be involved in tech in some form or fashion. Dude, our whole industry is based on tech.
It is.
So I feel like my role is just to spread the word and share how fun it is, and also share about how many different point of views you can have. Whether you join this industry via marketing or technical background or sales, you can get in on the fun anyway. Like, honestly, there's so many angles, like I mentioned before, and that's really, I feel like, what my job here is to do, is continue pushing through, create my own personal brand, working with great companies, working with cool people like yourself to get this word out, you know? Like, the industry's changing. A lot of people are on their way out, you know, not necessarily, you know, on their way out of life, but moving into different ventures.
Yes.
And opportunity is opening up every day for younger people, and I think this is our time to step in and make some change and change the conversation.
Totally. I think you know, the industry is in a strong place right now.
Yeah.
Technological growth. We're seeing all these great things from, you know, obviously we're a mount manufacturer, so we can plug in all the displays and all the different trends that I see and how that's evolved. So it is something for young people to get excited about.
Oh yeah.
You know, when you say, hey, this giant video wall screen, I can teach you how to sell this, how to build this,
yep,
how to put it together, you know, those kind of bits of knowledge that if someone who's kind of just getting into and starting their career with, you know, it would be invaluable for them. But I think what the industry really needs to do is market itself better to those individuals. Prospect talents from maybe different areas,
yep,
and kind of find out, you know, who might be the right fit for my organization to take me to the next level. Because I probably, you know, we connect so well. I think we share a similar sentiment.
Absolutely.
We were brought into this industry kind of on a whim.
Yep.
And we ended up loving it, and we ended up being fairly successful in our roles. So if we can market the industry better, have a locomotive platform for people who might not necessarily know the industry yet but can be successful in it, I think if we were to advocate that message,
yeah,
further moving forward. And, you know, with SCM9 and the Youth and AV Reception Council, Infocom,
yep,
you know, it's definitely good avenues to kind of start that discussion.
Yeah, and our stories in the 9 are kind of similar in a way. Like, I was in the AV industry basically my whole entire life and didn't even know it existed. You know, and I think, like you said, we advocate for the same things, and the 9 definitely helps us get that message across to not, you know, only the generation behind us, but also to the generation before us, so they can take a different look and a different perspective and kind of change their way of thinking, and not only technology, but business models.
Absolutely. It helps seeing things from different perspectives.
Right.
You know, when you can kind of shed light on something that someone might be unaware of,
yeah,
and give that different angle on how to look at it, that helps out a ton. So,
yeah.
But yeah, so any questions? Do you have any questions for me?
I do.
Okay.
I do. So you came from a marketing background, but not necessarily in this space. So what excites you? What excites you about AV? Because a lot of people that are going to come into this industry aren't going to have a traditional background in our industry, right? So what excited you?
You know, for me, like I said, I'm going to speak a little bit on my bias for being a manufacturer. So I didn't know that TV mounts are going to be subreflex.
Yeah.
I didn't know that displays, audio system, control, content management, I didn't know that that was all so complex and so technical and detailed. But when you put all these systems together, it becomes something everyone wants to see in the product.
Right.
Whether it's a video wall in Times Square where you can take a selfie off, or whether it's your local retail store that has digital signage that helps you buy a purchase, everyone's involved in some instance of digital science or AV.
Right.
So for me, what excites me is, you know, telling people who don't necessarily understand it yet what it's capable of doing,
right,
is extremely huge.
That's great, because I mean, honestly, the thing is, you don't have to know this industry, you don't have to be the most technical, savvy person, but what you do need to have here to be recognized is passion. And I think that's why both of us were in the nine.
Absolutely.
You know?
It's fun to be passionate when you're around individuals who you have a lot of fun with.
That's all we do, brothers, have fun.
Absolutely, it's all about it. So, I guess one more question too. So we're talking about prospecting talent.
Yeah.
Right? How would you pitch the industry to someone who's saying, hey, you know, I'm a young college kid who's looking for a career, you know, I don't know what I want to do yet. Can you tell me a little bit about the industry and the space that you're in?
Oh, just tell them about the opportunity. Whether that person is in marketing or they're a programmer or they're into coding. Whatever the case is, I would tell them about the opportunities that they have, again, from all those point of views, you know. You want to code, you can do that. You want to market, you can do that here as well. So whatever you're passionate about, it's here in this industry, right now, you know, and it's always going to be there, honestly.
That's very true, for sure. So many avenues, so many great ways to enter the industry. We just got to talk about it.
Exactly.
Yeah, so thanks for joining me today. I really appreciate you taking the time to...
About time you had me on the show. No, I'm just kidding.
Overdue, for sure.
No, man, I love what y'all do with The Peak, man. You guys are always creating awesome content in The Peak, man. I'm sure it's going to go be far and be successful, so keep doing what you're doing, dude.
Thank you. I appreciate that. And then the next time I'm going to catch you is at Infocom. So keep in line or keep in tune with anything that we have going on for The Peak.
Oh, yeah.
We'll probably do an Infocom deep dive where we talk about what we're going to be doing. We have some cool events and everything planned out as well, so definitely stay tuned, and thanks for watching this episode of The Peak.